Hello, Scorpio. Welcome to your weekly forecast. This is your reading for the week ahead, September 25th through October the 1st, 2023. For all Scorpios that may be watching, Scorpio suns, moons, risings, Scorpios on the house cusp, if you have your sun in the 8th house or Venus in Scorpio, feel free to watch this reading. Keep in mind these are general forecasts and they may not resonate with everyone out there. So for the most accurate reading, with the most accurate outcome, please come get a personal private tarot reading from either me or your favorite tarot reader out there. Woo, that's a mouthful of words. Woo, 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 Scorpio. Let's get into it. For your reading this week, we are using two decks here. This is the Spacious Tarot deck. I do not know the author of this deck. There's some publisher information on the side there, and also, if you want to scan with your phone to download the guidebook, there's a QR code here. I did purchase this little deck off the Wish app for those of you who are interested in also getting it. For the Oracle messages today, we are using the Dark Mirror Oracle cards by Laura Saba. There is a little QR code here on the back as well if you'd like to scan to download the guidebook. And I also purchased this deck off the Wish app, so for those of you who want to get it, you might check there first, or you might check there again. Okay. Did I mention I offer personals? If you would like to book a personal private tarot reading with me, the easiest way to do that is to book through my scheduling page. That's up in the right-hand corner, like I mentioned before. All my social media information is down below in the description box. You can follow me on Facebook. You can follow me on Instagram. Let's see. What else? Patreon. Although I'm not active on Patreon, you can still follow me over there and see what kind of things I've done in the past over there. I was on there for quite some time doing readings. But if you want to look at my older content, feel free to do that. Check it out. Let's see. Scorpio. I just did Libra, so now we're on to Scorpio. Give me 6 cards for Scorpio's week ahead. What do they need to know, Spirit? What are the most important messages and energies you want to share with the sign of Scorpio for the upcoming week, September 25th through October the 1st? Guys, like, share, comment, and subscribe. If you are not currently subscribed to my channel, please do consider hitting that subscribe button right now. It really does help me out. And with that being said, Scorpio, let's go ahead and dive into this reading. Underneath the deck, we have the Four of Pentacles in reverse, Capricorn's energy. Someone is opening up here. Someone is letting go. Someone is being very charitable. Someone is throwing out the baby with the bathwater. Here we have the Eight of Wands. A lot of movement forward, growth and expansion. Child of Wands reversed. Oh, this is all over the place. The Chariot. Hearing something about a flood or the floodgates opening. We've had a lot of flooding lately and not in a good way. So I'm not sure what this is about. The energies seem a little bit haphazard and all over the place. How you see yourself today? We have the Six of Wands in reverse. Well, you could feel like you're not getting the attention you deserve, okay, or the recognition you deserve. You may feel like you're being passed over for the promotion. You may feel dishonored by a team member here. Yeah, you may just feel like you're being overlooked at this time, like you're being dishonored in some way. What is the theme for your week ahead? This could be happening on social media or just in general and, you know, whatever. Justice is in reverse here. There seems to be some karmic repercussions going on here. You could be dealing with some karma this week as a theme for your week ahead, or the justice system, or an injustice. Something is not fair, Scorpio. Now, it could be that someone is weighing their own self-interests more heavily than everyone else, and so there's selfishness here. Make sure that's not you. This is Libra's energy. The South Node is in Libra. Of course, you could be dealing with a Libra. Something here, though, there is some sort of imbalance when it comes to a karmic situation, right? At least that's how it's coming through this week. And it seems like there are large, I'm looking at the ripples here, okay? Depending on what side you're on, if you've acted morally and ethically in the eyes of the universe, then you will reap what you sow, and it will be fair, and vice versa. If you are on the other side of that equation, if you have not acted morally and ethically in the eyes of the universe, then you will reap what you sow, what you've sowed, and it will be fair. In the past, you learned a lesson regarding the Explorer of Swords in reverse. I'm seeing this as like the Knight of Swords here. Well, someone didn't speak up. Someone didn't take action. Someone here thought hard before they said anything. This could be holding back with words and speech. On the other hand, this could also be someone like doing something like internet trolling someone, like internet trolls or robo-texting, robo-calling. This could be verbal like battery here, like someone that just goes off on someone. I feel like this is you in the past thinking before you spoke to someone. You might have had some very choice words. I feel like you bit your tongue though in this situation, or someone did this with you, possibly an air sign, a Libra, Gemini, or an Aquarius. Something is not going in your favor this week though, Scorpio. So now I'm wondering if there's something here that you're holding back on. Why are you holding back on it? It has to do with communication or taking action. You're not taking action on something, but there's still an injustice here. It doesn't seem to be going in your favor either way. Let's see, your challenge is the Three of Cups. Your challenge is around a group of friends, people you consider to be your equals. I keep feeling like this is happening on social media. So this could be regarding a community of people. But see, in this card, there's three different cups. These are three very different cups. And they're on, you know, these two are on equal footing, but this one is higher than the others. Okay, so, but this card is about equality in friendships. It's supposed to be, you know, putting your emotions over your head. So this could be revelry, joyous times, getting together. It's supposed to be, it's a cups card, so it's emotions, but is this happening amongst your friends or a group of friends here or a community? That's in the challenge position. You may feel lonely, unsupported. You may feel like you're an outsider, or there's a challenge around a group of friends here or a community coming together. I don't know how that's related to this injustice here. What is the lesson you're learning now? The Ace of Swords. The lesson you're learning now is how to speak the truth and how to cut away anything that's no longer serving you. You may also be learning something about public speaking or doing something in the public eye. Well, yeah. I mean, the lesson has to do with the truth coming out about something here. And really, this could have to do with whatever this karmic situation is, this bad karma or this negative karma here. Yeah, people may have been gossiping here, doing things behind someone's back. This could have been a whole community of people, you know, like, for example, a community of gaslighters. This could have been like an entire race of people doing this as well. Like the entire blank community is gaslighting this other community over here. And the truth is coming out about that. It could be something like this. The polka dot people are gaslighting the yellow people or whatever, or just substitute the yellow polka dot people are gaslighting the black and white polka dot people. So it could be something like that. It could be people purposely not speaking up on behalf of a group of people in general to cause something like this to happen. So this could have been a group of people doing this to you, Scorpio. I mean, I don't know. This is getting ridiculous. This is ridiculous. Yeah, your gift is the Fool. Your gift is that you don't care. You're going to go off and do something anyway. You could have your North Node in Aries. Your gift is that there's a journey ahead of you, and you don't have to take all this baggage with you. Leave this behind. If you choose to take this direction, this is a wonderful direction for you. You have to carve your own way. You have to go your own way. If these friends or this community isn't supporting you and you feel that this is a major injustice and you're not getting the attention you deserve and, you know, you didn't speak up in the past or they didn't speak up in the past or there was internet trolls or whatever was going on here, the lesson is that you can only speak your truth. You know what the truth is. Great. The Fool. Your gift is the Fool. There's a new beginning here somewhere. Someone's finally opening up about something here, though. Someone's finally letting go. Well, the Justice card in reverse is a bit disconcerting for your week ahead. So there's definitely something in the court systems, the legal systems, or, you know, the karmic realms here. Could even be Akashic records. Let's see. What is Scorpio's shadow this week? We have Bride in a Cage and Envious Gluttony. How interesting. That is really masquerade underneath the deck. So there's two different energies here. Someone here is in like an Eight of Swords energy. They're trapped. Possibly trapped in a marriage or trapped in a relationship. Someone else here is greedy, gluttonous, possessive, jealous. This is like, this is someone that overindulges regularly. They're a pig, really. And this could be someone that feels very entitled to you, Scorpio, entitled to your energy. Or something is never enough for this person. They make you feel trapped. The masquerading part is the person that's pretending that everything is peaches and cream. You could be heading for divorce this week, Scorpio. You may be divorcing someone. I feel like the masquerade is over. Okay, the clown show, the circus, whatever, the three-ring circus, whatever this shit is, it's over. Okay, the truth is coming out. You better start spitting out that truth, okay? I don't want to hear no bullshit from nobody this week. Scorpio, start being a Scorpio. The rest of you people over here, whoever's in this Three of Cups energy, shut your pie holes. Quit gossiping and doing whatever you're doing. If you're unsupportive of the Scorpio, then get out of the way, okay? The reason why you're not getting the attention and recognition that you feel you deserve is because you're you're going out there and you're pretending like everything is okay and people can see through the facade. All right, Scorpio, so stop trying to pretend that you're the only Scorpio. There's people that have Scorpio in their chart. Okay, there's other Scorpios out there that are having to stand up and be Scorpios. Okay, so just because you're a Scorpio doesn't mean there's other Scorpios that don't see what's going on here. I don't know what this is. Only you know what this is. If you're watching this reading, I'm reading your energy. So don't shoot the messenger. If this isn't your reading, this isn't your reading. Don't take offense to it because not every Scorpio is going through whatever this is. Okay, so take it with a very tiny grain of salt. Thank you for watching, Scorpio. Have a great week.